Tuning in to Dunamis on Air and Sobo Enemy is my name. And this is the platform where the Word of God, the presence of God mixed together is being transported to the privacy of your home, the privacy of your office to be a blessing to you. Thank you for hooking up. Thank you for always sharing. Thank you for keeping tuned today. The topic we are considering today is no more procrastination. Before I begin today's episode, I want to tell you three stories that are related to procrastination. A man of God had a vision, and inside that vision, he saw Satan and some demons discussing on how to destabilize believers, how to destabilize the church, how to truncate the plan of God of growing the church, propagating the gospel, and getting sinners saved. And they came up with different suggestions. Do we blackmail the pastor? Do we cause division in church? Do we also tell them that God is not real? The Bible is not real? The Word of God is not real? The demons came up with several suggestions to Satan the devil. And Satan said, every suggestion you make is good, but the preacher can defeat you in his message. Preacher can defeat you in his message. And then one of the demons came up and made a suggestion and said in his suggestion, let us not do the rest of the things that are being advised, but let us ensure that believers are not in a hurry. Let the believers keep insisting that they still have time. It is not a matter of urgency. The rapture will take place. Jesus is coming back. The kingdom of God is not a matter of urgency. And when that suggestion was made, Satan accepted the suggestion. What does that mean? The suggestion never to be in a hurry, to postpone what you should do now till tomorrow, as it relates to your spiritual life, your eternal destiny in heaven, as it relates to the kingdom of God, is one of Satan's decisions. Is one of Satan's strategy to get at you, to get at the church. Don't let him win over you. Secondly, this is the story. Some years back, about 2 years back, I had set aside my first fruit, the first fruit of the church, and I put them together, and I was praying and asking God what to do with it. Many times, I gave it up to where we submit to and to our spiritual fathers. And many times I give it in our church. So this particular year, I kept that first fruit till the month of July. And when it was clear that I'm supposed to give it up, I started procrastinating. I would do it this week. I would do it next week. I would do it this week. I would do it next week. And a time came that the burden to do it now became very strong. So I could remember vividly on a Tuesday, I went out with my wife to go and give the first fruit. And after we dropped the first fruit, blessings were released on us. And then after that particular blessing, I heard an instruction to set aside 3 days to pray. So I set aside Wednesday, Thursday, Friday to fast and pray. That Wednesday, after I took the decision to fast and pray, it was raining, heavy rain. That I was fighting between me whether to postpone or procrastinate the fasting. But after a while, the Holy Spirit helped me that I defeated the thought to procrastinate the fast. And I still went on that 3 days fasting only with water. As I came out from that fasting on Saturday morning, God blessed us with a 30-seater coaster bus. The man that brought us the bus said, from that Wednesday, God started planting in his heart to give us a coaster bus. I would have missed out on that blessing if I had procrastinated. This is the third story. About 2 Sundays ago, that means Sunday before this last Sunday, I had a vision in church about a young man in church. He actually comes around to maintain some of the vehicles in church. So while I was preaching that Sunday morning, I had a vision. And I decided to see him privately after the service. So after the service, I sent one of the pastors to call him. And the pastors went, called him, and he came to my office and came with the pastor. And I told him that there is a plan to set you up and send you to jail. But if you can fast and pray, that plan can be averted. And I warned him. I said, I know you have certain things to maintain in church. Do that today, Sunday. Do that tomorrow, Monday, so that on Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, you can fast. As that Wednesday evening, when I was getting ready to leave the office, I asked the pastor, has that young man fasted? The pastor said, no. He said, we'll do it later. By Thursday morning, as soon as I arrived in the office, I've not even alighted from my car. The pastor walked to the car and said, that young man has just been arrested this morning. He called that he's in the police station. Many times, you don't know the danger and the destruction that you invite to yourself when you procrastinate. With these stories, I want you to take the issue of procrastination very seriously as we wrap up this subject matter today. In Luke chapter 9, verse 62, Jesus said, these are the sentences of Jesus. These are the statements of Jesus. These are the words of Jesus. He said, no procrastination. He said, don't put God's kingdom till tomorrow. He said, seize the day. These are the very words of Jesus. These are the very words from the word of God. He warns us against procrastination. He warns us against procrastination. There are several synonyms that define procrastination. It is dragging one's feet. That's a synonym that defines procrastination. Dragging one's feet. It also means to hesitate. It means to delay the right actions. To delay the right actions. To delay the right actions. To delay the right actions to later time. That's a synonym to the word procrastination. It also means adjournment. Adjournment. Maybe you are in a meeting and the goal for the day is not completely decided on. They say we adjourn this meeting till a further date. That is a synonym of the word procrastination. Adjournment. It also means that you are postponing till tomorrow what should be done now. I would like you to know that when you push today's duty tomorrow, you are increasing tomorrow's burden. When you push today's duty till tomorrow, you are increasing tomorrow's burden. You are increasing tomorrow's workload. It is easy when you do it today. It will become hard when you shift it to tomorrow. And it will be very impossible if you shift it till a later date. It will be easy if you do it today. It will be hard if you decide to do it tomorrow. And it will be very impossible if you take the decision to procrastinate it till a future date. You must recognize that procrastination is demonic, and you must not allow it to take a hold on your destiny. You must not allow it take a hold on your destiny. You must not allow procrastination take a hold on your destiny. Delaying the right duty is the devil's delight. When you delay the right duty, Satan is delighted in it. It's not without consequences. When you procrastinate, it is not without consequences. What are the consequences and the cure for procrastination? That's what I want to deal with today. The consequences and the cure for procrastination. Just few of them because of the brief time that we have. Consequences for procrastinating. Number one, you must recognize that procrastination has consequences. The first one is that you will lose time and you will lose opportunity. You will lose your time and you will lose opportunity. In Acts chapter 24, verse 25, there is a man that is called Governor Felix. He had audience with Apostle Paul, and Apostle Paul presented the message of salvation, and he procrastinated his conviction. He procrastinated to make Jesus the Lord of his life, And if you study the entire Bible, there is no record he ever had any other opportunity. When you procrastinate, you lose time, you waste time, you destroy time, you waste opportunities. Greatness is tied to time and opportunity maximized. Number two, when you procrastinate, mistakes are inevitable. Procrastination. Genesis chapter 19. That was one of the reasons why Lot's wife became a pillar of salt. He procrastinated. If you read the story in Genesis 19, the angel of God needed to hurry them, hasten them. But even in the midst of God's mercy, hastening them out of Sodom, mistakes still took place that Lot's wife became a pillar of salt. And the Bible reminds us that we should remember Lot's wife. In the New Testament, we should remember Lot's wife. Number three, there will be unrealized goals, whether they are spiritual goals, physical goals, destiny goals. You cannot actualize your dreams, your goals, your visions. They cannot become a reality when you are given to procrastination. So it can ruin your career. It can ruin your business. It can ruin your destiny. God forbid. So today you must take a decision against procrastination. Number four, it can damage your reputation. When you are given to procrastination, maybe as a businessman, I will deliver the job tomorrow, next tomorrow, you keep procrastinating. It will go around that man is never serious. He is given to procrastination, and that can ruin your reputation. Yes, number five, it impacts on your health. A whole lot of stress, anxiety, worry, and regret, they are tied to procrastination. And it in turn impacts on your health. So it damages your health. When you regret of what you could have done because you didn't do it on time, it impacts on your health. So you must recognize that these are the five consequences of procrastination that we can take on this particular episode. What is the cure for procrastination? Number one, think reward. Ask yourself questions. What will my life become if I do the right things now? Think motivation. Nothing motivates us to stop procrastination like the reward. Jesus Christ foresee the exaltation, the glory ahead of him. So he did what he needed to do right on time. Be motivated by the reward. Reward is always a factor. What you stand to gain is a factor that will help you change positively. Number two, set goals. Let your goals have deadline. Avoid distractions. Get yourself into the right mode. Get yourself into the right environment so that you can discharge your goals. Yes, number three is that you set your goals. Number two is you set your goals and then have deadlines. There is something I would like to say. You need to maximize your power hours. Your power hours. There is a particular hour of the day that your mind works at its best. There are many people that if they don't eat breakfast and they get to work, they work better. And there are people that if they don't eat breakfast and they get to work, they cannot work better. Whichever one best suits you, make sure you maximize your power hours. The hours that you are functioning, your mind is functioning at maximum, at optimum. That is the hour that you maximize. Some people function best at midnight. So maximize those power hours, those power moments, so that you can achieve your goals at the time you have set them. That is number two cure for procrastination. And then number three, commit your decision to the Holy Spirit for help. No matter the determination to overcome procrastination, without the help of the Holy Spirit, you cannot achieve them. John 15 verse 5 says, without me, without my help, without my backup, you can achieve nothing. I believe you have been blessed by today's episode. as we wrap up this subject matter of procrastination. Jesus Christ said, no procrastination. Don't put the kingdom of God to tomorrow. He says, seize the day. I want to believe that you will obey the voice of Jesus. I pray for you that as we get ready to end this month, that God will put an end to rejection in your life, an end to disappointment in your life, an end to near success syndrome in your life, an end to a dry season in your life. I say God will put an end to disappointment, to sickness, to disease, to bitterness, to stress, every ungodly thing around you. As we get ready to end this month, I prophesy that God will come true for you, and those negative seasons are coming to an end in the name of Jesus Christ. I bless you with a miracle that will produce money and will meet you at the point of your need. Sicknesses are gone. Nightmares are gone. If you're sick, I release the anointing of healing. Rise up and walk. Let the pain vanish away. I release favor for miracle job, miracle money in the name of Jesus Christ. As you take a decision never to procrastinate, I speak to you that your lost grounds shall be fully recovered. Your wasted years shall be fully recovered. God will compensate you this remaining part of the year with uncommon breakthroughs, and you will have a testimony to share. Never forget that whatever God can do was meant to happen to you. It has happened, and it will keep happening as you keep sharing and watching Dunamis on Air. Please share it to 5 of your friends. Shalom, and God bless you.
You, God bless you. It's my pleasure to come your way just now. It's not by coincidence that I'm speaking to you in the privacy and the comfort of your home, maybe in your car, maybe in your office. And so Bodinam is my name, and I want to seize this medium to invite you to any of our services in church, Heaven's Diplomat Ministry, either the visual service online or the actual service on ground. Our service days are Sunday. We have 4 services. First service is by 6:30. Second service, 7:30. Third service, 8:30. And then the last service, healing and deliverance service, is by 9:30. God heals HIV. God heals COVID-19. People's lives have been changed just by being a part of any of our 60-minute service, just 60 minutes, online or on ground. I promise you by the Spirit of God that you will experience the reality of God, the reality of the Word of God, the reality of the power of God, the reality of the love of God in Heaven's Diplomat Ministry. God is real. We believe that whatever God can do, it was meant to happen to you. If you try God in any of our services, surely whatever God can do will happen to you. Thursdays we meet by 5:30 p.m. I'm inviting you to this supernatural experience. I'll be glad to meet you in any of our services. Invite your friends and share the testimony after such encounter. Shalom. God bless you. You'll see the details of the address on the screen and how to hook up to any of our services online. Thank you, and God bless you.